Well, good day, tubes. How is she hanging? Holy freaking crap, it's hot here today. yeah, and it sucks. It's really hot. But anyways, 5 minutes today I got spare. It's been, like I say, one of them days. Oh, crap, this is my last bottle of water. Holy cow, I've been going through that stuff like it's water, basically. Let me just have a quick swig here. What we're doing here. Oh, how come some days you just can't get enough water? Anyways, what we're doing here is tomorrow, unfortunately, I have got a cremation or a baby infant funeral to bury, which kind of sucks. I hate doing them. anyways, these sticks, these are some sticks that, I don't know, they were left here, and you only use them like maybe once every couple of years. These things are, you put these over the hole, and you basically just put some straps over top. They lay the casket down on it. Let a wee casket that's about 3 feet long by, I think he said, a foot wide by about a foot tall, roughly. So anyways, I haven't got any white paint. I do, however, have some of this Dremclad black paint. So we're just going to give these a little touching up here. Unfortunately, that's all I can do today for you guys. It's just been, like I say, another one of them awesome days where, holy cow, everything always happens on a Monday. Here, anyways. So I'll just give these a little cleaning because they've been sort of hanging up for a while and they don't really look too bad, but the white gets marked up real quick and easy. So these aren't even like really like a wood. I think I swear these are a piece of someone's old window frame. You know, I could probably get some better stuff, but I don't have any right here, which that looks like it's a 1x2. Could probably get away with 1x3, so that'd be 2¾ or something by 2. I wasn't even quite 2 there. But you know, these will work. It's just, it's a crappy thing, right? So, but anyway, I'm just gonna give these a little paint. Get some of this stuff out of your foreground so you can kind of watch this a little bit. And hopefully by tomorrow they're good to go. So yes, I had full intentions today, actually, of digging into that box of Coleman stuff that I had pulled out of that old rotten trailer, camper trailer. But then they came in all of a sudden, springed in, and yeah, we need a grave for tomorrow. Okay! Oh. I did that pretty quick. But sometimes it's the way she works. You're working on call like all the time with this job here. There's no plan hardly for anything. It's kind of a spur of the moment thing. Hence half the videos I make for you guys are kind of a spur of the moment thing. So I know painting's boring, but you know what? Thought I'd throw the camera on just for you guys and do some painting and some yakking and go from there. Yeah, these are like, I'm gonna have to replace these. I should have just done that today, I guess, but I don't, like I say, have any of that lumber here. If I did, I would have just cut some new ones, painted them, drive on, because these are definitely someone's old window frame wood stuff. It's like, wow, really? It's what they used here, you know. So before I started here, some of the old board members and stuff, they were, you know, some of the old guys where it's like, you know, you got a dime in your pocket, well, Let's see if you can get two dimes in your pocket without spending anything on anything. That's the way they seem to work back then, you know. It was like, unfortunately, or fortunately for me, when I started here, there were still a few of the old guys, but a lot of them have passed on now, or, yeah, passed on. 3-4 of them are gone now since I started here. They were old guys when, like, you know, my father-in-law started before me, so thankfully a lot of the newer guys know what things cost, you know, and how much things are, and they're, a lot of them, well, most of them are under the, you know, impression or whatever you would call it, as, holy cow, if you just need, like, a piece of wood, just go freaking get it. Like, we don't need to have a huge meeting over that, right? Which they used to before, apparently, if you needed a screwdriver or anything. Oh, well, we better have a big discussion about that before we go spend $3 on a screwdriver. So, fortunately for me, it's been pretty good. Okay, now, how the heck am I going to do the other sides? I don't know yet. This stuff doesn't really dry too wicked fast. Hopefully it's dry for tomorrow. Ooh, I never thought of that. Kind of wish I had some white, though, because white would look nicer, but what I'll do is maybe put them, stand them up or something after they've hardened for a little bit. Put the fan on them, that'll help dry them. So I think I've painted these white once. They look like they were like a dark green once. So they've had a few different colors anyways. Anyways, it's been wicked hot here. We're under, of course, the, you know, the severe thunderstorm warning right now. There's something apparently on its way, so we could desperately use some rain, though. Well, that'll make the grass grow again, which would suck, but yeah, it's been horrendously, I would say now, horrendously dry out there with no rain at all. Grounds. I just finished digging this one here, and it was 3 foot long grave, 2 foot wide, about 3 foot deep roughly, and it was pretty much dry right to the bottom of that. So it's like, wow, it's really, really dried up the last week or so even. And today we've had a fairly nice windy day, which I guess is the start of the storms pushing through, and it's been extraordinarily windy, which doesn't help with, you know, dry ground. Of course, it can't get much drier if it's already dried out, I guess. So, okay, how the frick am I gonna hold these while I'm doing the other sides here? Well, I'm not too sure. Anyways, maybe we'll just try. I'll just try holding a little strap in here, maybe, and trying to paint her down, and we'll just try to hang them up overnight. You know what the beauty thing is, though? It's like, I don't know, 34 degrees outside and crappy hot and stuff, but in here, so I'm still sweating, but it's got to be at least 20 degrees cooler in the shop here. Now, that will change real fast if you left the door open, of course, but I guess with all the insulation and the, you know, the cold cement floor. Okay, this isn't maybe not going to work. The cold cement floor. She's, kept it pretty darn cold. We don't have an air conditioner unit yet in our house, although our travel trailer has a pretty darn good one. I was sleeping there last night, family didn't want to. I'm like, okay, I'm sleeping out in the trailer because it's nice and cold. And holy cow, it was probably 69 degrees. Just a little bit, a little room temperature in there, no humidity. I was actually shivering. It was so awesome. So yeah, that was pretty cool. Okay, we'll call that one done. I gotta find somewhere here to hang it. I got a wire thing here in the wall. I'm just gonna hang it from that, I think. Kind of, sort of. And okay, so now we'll get to just check you guys and make sure you're still good. Yeah, you're not too bad there. I guess we can turn you a little bit. So yeah, we're supposed to cool down tomorrow to like 21 degrees, which is about 70 degrees for you guys down south there, so you get an idea what we're looking at. So that's like room temperature-y kind of stuff. I don't so much mind the heat. It's that humidity crap that really gets me going. Holy, I don't like that part. Because you could have a real hot day with no humidity and you don't even really notice it, but wouldn't you add all that extra moisture to it, all trapped on top of you and stuff, it sucks. Especially if you gotta work outdoors. All you do, I know you don't like that part of it either. I couldn't imagine being on like a construction crew or a roofing guy today. That would suck. A roofer, oh. Or even just a general contractor guy, builder guy. That would probably really be hot. I think the roofing would be the worst though. These guys up there, no shirts, you know, barely wearing a pair of shorts because it's so bloody hot. But yeah, you know what? You really should be up there with long sleeves on. You can put all the sunscreen on you want. You're still gonna get too much sun and end up probably with some kind of skin cancer-y stuff. That one guy that did our roof, or that one company there that did our roof there about 2 years ago, he was like freaking leather. He was so freaking like cooked. I'm like, holy geez, bud, that is insane. So, okay, we got two bars here. I'll just give you a little turn because of course you can't see. Two bars are hanging. Now we need a little bit of a fan. To blow some air, but I don't want to blow too much air on them. But I think I'm gonna have to go get my little extension cord, because I don't think that's gonna quite reach over the plug way over here. So we'll go get a cord. All right, so yeah, it's gotta be at least 20 degrees cooler in here. Holy geez, it's really hot out there today. It sucks. I guess the insulated windows and stuff too really make a huge difference, eh? Like the having the insulated windows is going to be super awesome this winter too, I think, because they were really letting a lot of crap in. I do believe disposable paintbrushes, gotta love that. So cheap, they're not even worth cleaning. Okay, so let's crank this probably onto one. Up top, but not too bad down here below-ish. So we'll let them dry, I guess. They should be hopefully good by tomorrow. I need them tomorrow by noon, so yeah, it should be probably all right by tonight. But yeah, that should work.
Sweet.
So I had one of these stupid things break the other day on my mower. This is the thing where that goes there, and then this piece goes there. You remember? Get a better shot here. That goes there, that goes there, and your wheel goes on this part. They always seem to snap for some reason here. They start going, and then where am I here? Where am I? So you can see the down there, she had already broken a bit, and then I guess I must have hit something or whatever, and just, I didn't even know it came off. My wife found it. So I looked at the thing, I'm like, holy freaking crap. Really? How the heck did that come off?
But there's not much there for all that string, you know, so kind of a stupid design, really, but these, I guess, are like a bolt thingy that just goes through this, and then they just mush with the presser or something, squash it. That's it. You can't really do much with them. You could probably, get that just lined back upright. But there somewhere, and weld around the thing here, around the outside. But I mean, I got like a bunch of these in stock because I've had trouble with one before. So out of my drawer of John Deere stuff out here. Oh, it's gonna be hot out here from this to, oh yeah, it's gotta be 20 degrees hotter out here at least. So yeah, out here I got three more of them. So we got a few more spares, you know, so there's what they kind of look like newish. But yeah, you can see us just kind of squashed, friction fitted, or whatever you call that. So we got nuts with them too. These nuts are weird. Can't keep nothing normal. They got everything weird. So some more John Deere bucket tooth stuff. Yeah, a little bit of everything. So, but anyways, yeah, she's brutal hot out here today. It's been really crappy, and I've been out here since freaking like 8 o'clock mowing, doing lots of mowing. To heck with the weed whacking today. I can frig right off. There's no way I'm walking around with a bloody weed whacker today. A lot of stuff isn't too bad anyways, it doesn't kind of really need done, so. A couple areas, the one behind the church way back over there kind of needs sort of done, but all it is are these freaking stupid stick weeds. I don't even know what they call them, horsewhip weed or something. Horsetail, these stupid things here that keep freaking growing, like overnight. And they get really woody. So, I mean, that's, the grass isn't doing anything hardly here. It's all the frickin' weeds, right? So, that frickin' sucks, and I frickin' hate frickin' cutting those, because if you leave them too frickin' long, they frickin' dull your mower blades, because the frickin' things turn to frickin' dirt, or turn to frickin' wood. So, they're really hard on your mower blades, right? Because the very bottom where you're cutting them, they turn almost woody. Like a woody, stemmy kind of thing. And, yeah, and it sucks. Really sucks, so. If I don't keep them kind of cuttish down, you're replacing blades and sharpening blades a lot more than kind of normal, so that kind of sucks. But anyways, yeah, I wanted to get into that box of the Coleman stuff up there and start, trying out that camp stove. I think there's a camp stove in there, and I think there's a lantern too. There's actually another lantern there too. There's two lanterns, I think. There's one Lucy one in the trailer, and then there was one in that plastic tote. And honestly, that trailer sat there. Okay, let me really think about this. I think Dylan might have been two when we actually camped in that one night, just in the backyard. It was in pretty rough shape, so we never really took it anywhere, actually at all, I don't think. to actually camp with it. And maybe we did one place, I can't remember now. I don't really remember, that's been a long time ago, so. But yeah, so he's 12 now, so that thing's, stuff's been sitting there for, okay, I gotta go back where it's cooler to begin with. That sucks standing up here. Yeah, it's really hot in here for some reason because there's no roof vents at all on this side. So all the heat, if you went up top there today, like up here, it would really suck. It's probably about 45 degrees up there. But anyways, oh yeah, way better in here. It smells like paint now though. But yeah, anyway, so those things probably haven't seen light for 10 years, I'm gonna say. And I don't really think we even used them that I can remember too much before that. So, I imagine you could probably look up like the date, maybe off the side of the coat of the thing. I know they're probably pretty darn old, but I wouldn't be surprised if they haven't been lit in maybe over 20 years. So really, that's pretty crazy. But anyways, maybe if I get time tomorrow, maybe we can have a look at one of the Coleman lanterns. Now I know I've got one, and I can't remember if it's one of those two lanterns. And I don't know if there's something wrong with the, I don't really know what our proper name for them now, it's been so long. The little thing that injects the fluid, you know, you pump it up. Fill it up first, pump it up, and then you turn on the whatever they call that thing. I can't remember. You guys maybe know. I don't know if that thing or something was wrong with whatever, but it kind of used to turn into like a little bit of a flamethrower. It was kind of scary. I think once it kind of got going for a while, it kind of settled down and it was all right. And then the mantle actually lit up, and then it worked, you know. But it starts like, and it goes like 4 feet above the freaking lantern itself. So. I'm gonna have to light that outside. That's probably not very safe to be having her inside, but I don't really know which one it was. And downstairs in my house, I know I've got like at least two or three other camp fuel ones, and I know I've got a propane one, which is totally boring. But I don't know, the camp fuel ones have always been like really interesting to me, how they work and stuff, and you know, they actually will cook stuff for you, which is kind of cool, you know, and it's like that white gas or whatever they call it, the white gas or camp fuel or whatever they call it. And for some weird reason, as far as I know, it never seems to go bad, because I've remember lighting these things, there was still fuel in them, I think, and they just fired right up, you know, and that was like 10 years ago. So I don't know, maybe they won't work at all, they might be all the little orificey thingies might be all full of crap and not work at all. I don't know. I've never had them open for like the last 10 years at least. So it'd be kind of interesting to see what's going to happen. But because we'd probably take maybe one of those with us if when we go camping, you know. Which we got it. Oh, for freak's sakes, I got crap all over me. Which we do have some trips planned in the next, not for a while yet, but. But you know, our trailer's got the propane stove or whatever have you in it, you know, so we probably only need one of those things, but I don't know, it might be outside or something, might be a alright thing. Lantern, they make such good battery operated ones now, I don't know, it's probably not even really worth having one of those anymore, except the, you know, antique value of it, so we'll say. They smell, they, you know, the stink's kind of nasty with them. They're kind of a pain in the arse to get going. Once they're going, they're all right. You got to keep, you know, pumping the little tank up with stuff, make sure it's full. I mean, they'll run a long time on a little tank, but I don't know. Like, you know what? I've never really had a use really for one, but for some reason I've got like six of them. I don't know. But there is a place actually down the city, Mississauga somewhere, I think, that you can get all the parts and stuff for them. I'm sure you can get them all online too, like all the little, I know on the burners on those stoves there's these little, I guess it's where the actual gas comes out and the flame starts, so there's like a circle thing, sits like this, and the gas comes out and then flames that way, right? They're little crinkly little disc thingies. I know some of them, they go rusty and then it doesn't kind of work too well, but I'm sure you can get all those parts. You can get the some of them, well, I guess most of them have like the little tank with that long injector thingy that injects it into the orificey thingy and then into the burner thingies. I'm pretty sure you could get all them new. I've got some. I know a couple of my ones are really, really old. And you guys probably would maybe recognize the red tank ones where they're like a sandwiched kind of tank and they're crimped around the edge. I've got some that are like a hollow tube. It's like a copper tube and they got caps on the ends. That's your tank. They're really old. I think they're from like the 60s or early 50s or something. I don't really know, but you know, we'll have to get them out and have a look. Maybe I'll grab the ones downstairs tonight and I'll bring everything all down tomorrow and we'll try lighting some stoves up and some lanterns up and stuff. I think that'd be kind of fun. Get them all going again. Make sure, you know, see if everything works and see what I got for the inventory. If I need some parts or if I got enough freaking stoves. Like, you know, really only need one, maybe two if you're cooking a lot of stuff. But yeah, that'd be kind of sweet maybe. So, but other than that, holy frig, it's been last week. I am still exhausted from last week, and I just started this week. Plus, I wasn't feeling good too, right? A little better now. I can talk and not really hacking. The odd time I get like the little, oh, I'm gonna hack, but no, got away from it. But yeah, so last week was holy frig. That was a busy week. You know, you tell people, oh, I had 7 funerals last week, and they're like, oh, that's not too bad. They don't realize how much work that is. One funeral for one person is a lot of work. Now, mind you, a couple of them, well, let's go to a little bit more stories here. Hopefully we got enough battery here. I don't know if I do or not. Anyways, hang on a second. Yes, I think I got enough battery for now. 61% still there. So anyways, yes, last week was interesting. I can't remember which days they were on now because I tried to block it out, I think. But the one day, which I do believe was the Wednesday, I had 3 funerals. I had the one full-size way at the back, which was fine. A little bit of a tight spot to get into, but it was fine. Then I had the 2 cremations over in the niches over here, the columbarium niches. That was fun. The the guy we were burying in that, I guess, prepared everything for his wife, you know, and prepared everything for himself when his wife had died. They buried her in there with an urn that was, it's kind of hard to sort of show you, but it was about 8 inches wide by about 10 inches tall by about another 10 inches. So this box inside, the cremation niche itself, is 12 by 12 by 12 by 12. So that meant there's not much room left. On the one side, I think there was about this much, maybe 2 inches, and maybe 2 inches on the top, and like nothing, it was right almost to the door, right? So I pulled the door off, families stand. There's only 2 people actually that came, which was kind of good. And I look at him like, what are you planning on putting in here? They're like, oh, why? I'm like, can I back up and show them? And they're like, oh, he's got the exact same urn. I'm like, well, that's not going to fit. You've got about 2 inches by about 12 inches wide. So, you know, like a space about this big to put something in, and that's it. And he's like, I guess he was a nephew or something. He's like, oh, wow. I thought he might have planned that a little better. Kind of left us out to the dry with that one, didn't he? I'm like, well, sorry. He did her funeral, I guess, and then ordered the exact same thing for him. Yep, I'll get the same thing. And nobody ever thought of measurements right down here. So, anyways, they ended up calling the funeral home, which wasn't a funeral home from around here. They were north of us, which was kind of crappy, but they ended up coming down with what they call a companion urn, which is basically a box like that, but a little bit taller. It was about 10 inches tall. And then there's room inside for 2 urns, plastic boxes that come out. So they switched everything over to these 2 boxes, put that in, and slid the guy in, slid them both in, and good. Done. But as we're doing that, an hour later, when we started doing this first one, the second funeral come in and was waiting. I'm like, oh, freaking crap, holy jumping. We weren't expecting to get a dilemma like that, right? So anyways, they were fine, they waited, blah, blah, blah. So as the second funeral for the niche was kind of getting underway and going, my full-size third funeral come in, had to all come past all these people. So they went back and did their thing. And, you know, I'm kind of up front here, kind of stuck with doing this niche, because I got to put the door back on and put the screws back on, seal it up, right? So they're getting pretty much done back there for this full size. And he comes out, gives me the paperwork. I'm like, oh, I'm going to be like another 10 minutes at least. Oh, that's okay. Blah, blah, blah is back there still. I'm like, okay. So I got her finished and then went back, and yeah, it was probably about 20 minutes after the guy had left, you know, that said they were finished, and maybe even half an hour or so. I'm like, oh, guy's been standing back here the whole time. I'm like, holy crap, that sucks. But I mean, that's what happens. You book stuff on top of each other like that, that's what happens. So it's like, what do you want me to do about it, you know? I can't, you know, really say to them, no, no, God, I can't do that. I got another one right now to do, so. But that day sucked. That was, I think, Wednesday. Thursday. Thursday was okay. Another really, really crappy spot to get the big backhoe parked in. I had to sit kind of, I don't even remember now, it was cockeyed, and then the digger was this way, and I had to lift it up and over the stones and into the trailer and then drive away. That wasn't the worst part. The worst part was I got all these open ones back there. This section's been really hammered again this year with funerals. So I had to like weave my way through monuments and stones to get to a road that I'm not driving over like a fresh grave and making a huge mess, right? So that sucked. Oh man. But anyways, that one got in, was fine. That was Thursday. Friday. No, that was Friday. I can't even remember now. Wednesdays was the three. Thursday. Friday. Saturday. Saturday was the one where these people just like randomly come up to the house. Yeah, my dad died yesterday. We need to buy a plot for him for tomorrow. I'm like, okay. So the funny thing was, not really funny, but you know, they didn't know what I guess to do. But they're banging on my door asking to get a plot, but they hadn't even been to a funeral home yet to do any of that pre-arranging stuff. So like no dates were really set, no nothings were set, and they figured, oh yeah, we'll just do it tomorrow, like the day after he died. It's like, well yeah, I can have a hole ready by then, not a whole lot of notice for me really, but I can have it done by then, but I guarantee you the funeral home won't be able to do it for you. So yeah, sure enough, I sent them up the road here to the funeral home, and he's like, texts me after, yeah, it's gonna be Saturday at 11 o'clock service or whatever it was. I'm like, oh, okay, well, it's a little bit different. So that would have been like two on like Thursday, and I only had one on Wednesday then. That would have kind of sucked for two on Thursday again. But anyways, yeah, so we did that on Saturday. Everything was good, blah, 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 and on we go again. So lots of fun. And I'm out mowing this morning, and then the funeral home guy just comes flying in with the car behind him. I'm like, oh, I know what that means. Right off, I know what that means. Someone's passed away, and they're looking for graves for something. So sure enough, it ended up being, I guess they lost a baby, which sucks. And we have to do that one tomorrow, because I guess they don't want to do embalming or anything on a baby, you know, or whatever. They're just going to put them in, dress them or whatever, clean them, dress them, put them in a little box. And Bob's your uncle, I guess you sort of kind of say whatever. But yeah, that's tomorrow, so that's going to be fun. And I don't know, he threw like three other texts at me for different stuff too. I'm like, holy freaking crap, do you like seriously store up like a whole bunch and then just loading them all on me all at once? Like, my God. Like, I'm surprised I'm able to get any grass cut at all around here with as much stuff as he's thrown at me this last like freaking month. Holy jumping. Oh. I don't know, it seems to be getting really busy again, and luckily the grass is kind of burnt off and it's not really growing, so that's kind of good. It lets me do this other stuff, you know. But I'm kind of waiting for this storm to come. It's supposed to be at 3:30-ish. It's 4:14 now, and there's no rain. It's like still super nice and sunny out. But when I was a kid coming home from school, we used to get out at 3:20. And I think it was about 4:30 that day when I got home from school after it got frickin' night black. Like, I mean black, I mean
black.
I mean black. And it frickin' was really bad. That's the year we had that tornado come north of town, jumped the highway, took out that whole plaza up the road, went through a whole bunch of farms, down another hill, up, wrecked a whole bunch of trees, and just made a huge mess. You wouldn't even know it now, it's all grown up. That was in like 1986, I think it was, so it's like a long time ago now, right? So that's 30 years ago. May 1986, I think it was. So holy crap, that's over 30 years ago. Yeah, there you go. But it was for like at least 20 years after that, you could see the path still where it went, and it just everything out, so that really got demolished. But hopefully that doesn't happen. But we really could use some rain because it's really, really dry out there. And there's been, actually, it was weird this morning. I was out watering the garden and stuff, the flowers, and the grass is actually coming pretty good now. It's all green looking over there now. We'll look at that maybe on the way home. I was out doing that, and I was out, probably just about lunchtime doing that. And there's been people dragging hoses like crazy out there, watering stuff, watering the grass. It's like, really? Does the grass really matter? Really? That much? Okay, I can see your flowers that you've spent a pile of money on. Okay. But watering the grass, standing there for an hour watering grass is kind of really pointless. I mean, that's really stupid doing that. I've given up, honestly, because the ground is so dry. I was standing out there watering people's, you know, stuff. It's not doing a frickin' thing at all. All it is just getting absorbed in a little bit, and then you can almost see it evaporating, right? So I'm like, oh, forget that. But anyways, back to that story. I got the water going for the grass here, because it's at the entrance, right? It's got to look kind of nice, right? And then the flower garden gets, you know, water too by the water thing. But anyways, I let that go for probably half an hour, shut her off. I wanted to do a little bit of cleaning up around the other spot there, so I got the hose going, and I'm like, washing, you know, with the hose thing. And all of a sudden, it's like, I'm like, it's like blowing air. There's like air coming out. I'm like, well, that's not kind of good. That kind of almost means like the well's been sucked down kind of to where the pump is, like way down like 280 feet. And I think the water was kind of, what do they call it? Staticked or whatever they call it at, I think about 14 feet below ground level. So I'm like, that's a lot of frickin' water. That's a lot of water that's been put out on the grounds, you know? So I'm like, wow, if I'm getting air coming out here, that's probably not too good. Like air, you know, you got the hose going, and it's going, shooting out air like you just turned the line on. You know how you get air bubbles coming out? But this has been well purged. So I'm like, oh wow, that's not good. Maybe I better shut this off because I don't want the well to run dry because, you know, people are drawing out there for water and it feeds our house too, you know, and like, you know, it kind of sort of would be nice to have water in our house. So yeah, I'm like, oh, okay, maybe I better shut that off. Because I guess it must have been, I don't know. You'd think there'd be tons of water down there that deep, but I guess not. I don't know. So, yeah. So, I shut her off. I'm like, oh, that's maybe not too good. But it's been dry, really dry, and it's going to take a lot of frickin' rain to get water to replenish down below there. I still don't know how it does it. Like, you'd have to have, like, 2 months of rain up top, you think, to get the water down below. But I guess it's all other water down. It's not like a normal groundwater. It's, you know, like, subground water or whatever they call that. Way down low, so there, I guess there's lots of it down there, but yeah, that was kind of crazy. So I'm like, better not be doing that too much anymore. But people stand back there with the hose, and you know, and they're, I'm like, do you think it just grows on trees? This is just getting sucked out of that big lake back there? No, we're paying for this, you know, like it's the, yeah, they kind of paid for it too, but you also can't just stand there all day with a hose, you know, which is really going to do absolutely nothing except run off and feed the weeds, and the weeds will grow on basically no water, but the grass will. I think now we'll need at least a week of rain to bring it kind of back and saturate the ground again enough for it to grow, because it's just freaking wicked dry. Like, I think I might have mentioned it when I dug that one for the baby tomorrow. It was down like 3 and a bit feet until I leveled it off, and it was dry the whole way down. So I don't know how anything lives off of that. You know, they must have really good roots all the way down to get the deep stuff, right? But holy jumping. Now, it's funny because the graves I dug, the last one I did, it was right down near the bottom, and it come out, and it was actually wet enough you could make a ball of dirt. So there's moisture down there, but just the first like 5 feet is garbage. It's just freaking burnt, like dried right out to nothing. So, but anyways, I guess that's enough babbling for today. I better carry on and get the frick going, and maybe tomorrow we'll play with some Coleman stuff, and I'll bring her down maybe in the morning, and hopefully my little dewy things are dry here, and we'll Put them out, and I got some, basically some seatbelt strap stuff somewhere. Where the heck did I put it now? I can't remember. I know they were on my shelf out there, but the shelf's long gone and disposed of. Well then, I'm gonna have to look. But basically, I just put these sticks down over the hole, lay the straps out, and they'll lay the casket on that, and when they're ready, they'll grab a strap on each side, pick it up, pull the sticks out, and then lower the baby down in to the bottom. And normally they'll throw the straps in the bottom, and then I gotta try to climb in there and get the frickin' straps out again, which sucks. But anyways, it's alright. That's alright. I think that's about it. About her for today. Oh! I had to order something from Rock Auto. Explain that to you just before we go here. So when I went to John Deere to pick up these pieces for my plow, these ones here, I had them, they're a bit longer than my bed of my truck, right? These are the cutting edges for that plow. Snow plow, snow blade. They were sticking out about here off the tailgate, so I thought, ah, oh, geez, it's going to be really heavy to lift them up and then put the gate down with one hand and one hand. So I'm like, okay, I'll just slowly lower it down. Well, what happened was the thing freaking went down and slid across the bottom and smacked into the corner, the bottom corner of my taillight. So like right, you know, like where the plastic comes around and then it kind of goes that way. It didn't chip that whole side off. Well, now the whole lens, I guess, has leaked moisture in and it's all wet inside. So I ordered a new lens. So yeah, I ordered a new taillight lens for the truck. Wasn't really too bad. I think it was like $120 or something shipped. So I'm like, the heck, eh? That's not too bad. So that's on its way. Well, I'm gonna have to replace that, I guess. Because I guess it just chipped the thing open a little bit and it got a little bit of moisture into it. Now it's all like, you know, like, what do they call that? Not like foggy inside, but it's all like, wow, moisture inside of it. I don't know, I guess it gets in there and then it doesn't get out again, right? So I just ordered a new one. We'll switch everything over and go from there. And my mistake, I left the tailgate down. Those things kind of got away on me and then kind of chipped the light on the corner. This is a while ago now, but just recently it's done this moisture thing. Condensation, that's I think what I'm thinking of. So yeah, we're gonna have to replace that, unfortunately. Yeah, I had the truck in there to get the air conditioner looked at, and they apparently found a O-ring that was leaking. I guess they did the dye test to put the dye in, and they run it, and then they put the UV light over it, and they can see if there's any dye coming anywhere on any of the joints or fittings that it's there's a leak there. So apparently they replaced the O-ring, evacuated the system, recharged the system, and good to go. Now, I think there's something a little more, because it's still not really cold like it should be, and the compressor's only turning on for about 5 seconds and then shutting off for like 10. Turning on for 5, shutting off for 10. And it's just barely getting the freaking cold going, and then it's turned off again, you know? So I'm like, something's definitely still wrong here. I think it's maybe the, I can't remember the name of it either, but it's the thing in line that's like a pressure sensor thingy, which basically tells the compressor to turn on. I had one go in the van, and I had this other spare van here, so I took the one out of that one, put it in this one, and then the van worked fine. That's all it was the little pressure switch in there, I guess, was screwed up or whatever, you know, and it wasn't telling the right thing, right? Like, they've recharged it, obviously, they know how to put it back and recharge it, and it's still not right, so I kind of think it's that, but I'm going to leave it for a little while, just keep checking it and trying it and seeing if it's all right. It'd be a good day today, actually. I'm going to go up and try her now. I'm going to go fire it up and sit in it where it's freaking cold. It better be freaking cold, but it's probably not going to be. Equipment, eh? Anyways, yeah, I'm going to head her up. Doesn't look like there's any rain coming. We just looked at the maps again, and it was just didn't look at all like anything coming this way. Something big went north of us, but it's missed us now, but no rain again. So anyways, yeah, I'm gonna head her out. I guess that's enough for this for today. Just way too hot. It's supposed to be. Okay, get this. There is a cold front coming through. All these storms or whatever are gonna come through, and then there'll be this cold front. It's supposed to be 12 degrees tonight. It's 33 right now. Really? That's crazy. Oh, these are drying.
I don't know if you can see that or not, but where the fan's really not hitting it up here, it's still, like they're, up here is still a bit tacky. So
it'll be dry by tomorrow. That should work good. But anyways, let's go up. I'll just maybe show you this light. We'll fire up the truck for a minute, sit in the air sea, and see how it's working. Another kind of factory kind of thing that I know it's kind of not working right is because it's not, it's not dripping much water. A day like this, it should be just pouring off the thing, you know, if it was working right, but it's not. So yeah, something's definitely still not right. Well, let's go have a look. Okay, so you can see the moisture in her, and I think right at the bottom here, I must have just chipped her a little bit, and that stupid thing fell and hit us, let moisture in there. So that freaking drove me nuts. I'm like, no, can't be doing that. So we're ordering a new one. So that's on its way. We'll replace that, and then whenever it gets here. And I got a friggin' light. Maybe we'll crush it with the little mini X or something. Holy friggin' crap, it's hot in here. Whew. Okay, let's see what happens here. I'm gonna let this run for, I don't know, a few minutes anyways. And holy friggin' crap, it's like 5,000 degrees in here. Look, 33 degrees Celsius. So I don't know what that converts to, but it's like 190 probably or something. I don't know. So the air is on and it's cooling. Like it's coming cool there, but it's not, I don't know how you'd say it. Like it starts to cool because the compressor's running, then it shuts off, and then it all, you know, warms back up again for 10 seconds and it cools down again. So it's definitely something not right. So, like I say, I'm gonna let it run like that for a little bit just to see kind of what happens. Maybe I'll go for a little ride here and come back and we'll see how she feels and see how that feels inside here. It doesn't actually have a thermometer in here for temperature inside your vehicle, but it's pretty darn freaking hot, let me tell you. Holy jumping. But today it should be condensing a lot of that water, and all the tubing and, you know, the dryer and all that crap should be condensing a lot of the water and stuff, and dripping off the bottom. And I don't know, we'll see. I'll go for a little tour here and then see what it's doing when we come back. And I'll go and feel the pipe, that one main pipe that goes into the exchanger. So it'll go, and then it blows the air through there and it cools that air, right? And then it comes into your cab. That's how that sort of works. Then it returns back, and then, you know, back through the condenser and blah blah blah. Yeah, so that's sort of how it works. I'm not a professor on air conditioner systems, but yeah. So anyways, I'll go for a little tour and we'll see how she gets. Okay, so we're just touring along here. It actually seems to be not kind of working really too bad. I mean, the odd time you can feel that you know, the moisture, warmer air coming in, and then, you know, it cools. Holy crap, look at down here. Log sim Saturday. Oh, it smells good too. Oh, they're loading logs right now. Sweet. We might have to stop and get a little bit of a footage of this. It's unloading maybe, I don't know. Looks like they're piling logs up here. Oh, that is freaking cool. Try to pull a little closer. That's pretty cool. I've done that in game. Although he's a lot neater pile than I'm doing. It's probably a lot easier to be actually doing it. It smells like Christmas trees. I guess some of the ice damage in here was pretty bad, so a lot of people are just like, pardon me, yeah, come clear it for me. Oh, she's got one that's a little bit wonky there. Gonna do it. Look at that, he just grabbed her right by the thing. Oh crap. That is a freaking cool machine. Just like Farm Sim, eh? You get the same thing. Look at that, he's grabbed her. There we go. Kablooey. That's a lot of frickin' logs there. Holy crap, they've done a lot of clearing. There, he's straightening up the rows. Somebody else will come and... somebody else will come and get the logs on a big truck probably then. I guess he grabs what he can. That's actually pretty frickin' good. That's be a lot of weight there. I don't know, he's got 8 or 10 logs there anyways. That'd be actually a pretty cool job, you know that? Actually, that'd be kind of fun, I think. I'm all straightened, they're all straight again. Now, I don't know what these would be going for, but... probably just going to be going for chips, because they cut them pretty short. They're not going to be for poles, I don't think. Those are like a pine tree, they're not really good for in-ground. They go rotten pretty quick, like within like 5 years they'd be going rotten and breaking off, so. I kind of would imagine they'd be probably going for chipping, shredding, or whatever you want to call her. Yeah, all these trees up in here, that's what they're taking down, right? All these kind of guys here. There was a lot of ice damage there, so. There was, that guy's watching us, it's fun. There's a lot of places like this that just kind of clear cut the whole side of the hill because all the tops have busted off, so they're saving all the bottoms, I guess. So maybe I'll watch them unload all this. But anyways, the air seems to, even sitting here, it seems to kind of be cool. Like it's cooled off the whole cab. Everything feels cool now in here, so. I mean, I guess it's working. It's just I don't understand. Maybe it's me. Maybe that's what's supposed to happen. It's supposed to shut the thing off for a couple of seconds so it doesn't freeze up. I guess if it kind of ran too much, it would sort of freeze up on you, right? And then you'd be really bad. Really bad shape. Oh, but a little bit too much. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Looked like there, roughly. Oh, that was freaking cool. Pardon me. Flip them right around. He didn't like where they were sitting. Man, it's hard to hold this thing still when it's zoomed in. Those jaws are awesome on that thing, eh? Holy crap. I guess the guy would get paid, you know, the landowner here would get paid per linear foot or something of log. Like maybe $1 a foot or 10 cents a foot, I don't know. I have no idea what they'd be getting. I don't know what he's trying to do there. He's trying to reorganize them or something. Aren't hydraulics freaking cool though? You know how much work it would be to stack a pile like that for probably about 30 guys? Be like 30 guys of work there just to stack that. He's done her. I don't know how long, but I bet you that's just today. All nice and square. Does it look good, I guess? Makes it easier for the next guy loading, I guess, right? Whoa, he's gonna take the whole side off. Oh, that's a bit too much. Ay, ay, ay. Got him though, I think. Oh, it smells so nice too. If you know what Christmas trees smell like, it smells just like that. Love the smell of pine and working with pine and stuff, but it is horrible for stuff for outside. You know, unless it's treated, like the pressure treated stuff, that's about the only thing it's good for. So he's probably able to see us here now. That's freaking cool. He's got maybe two more loads there, and he'll be unloaded. Look at this thing rocking though now. Eh? Wow. Oh crap, dude, I'm gonna lose one. Oh no, couldn't get her. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 again. Oh my god, that's a lot of weight. Like one log is probably like 200-300 pounds, maybe. I don't know. Times 8. Do the math. Like holy frick, that's heavy. Surprised he can go out that far with it not fall over. I think that thing would probably have an extension on it too. Talk about good on the controls though, eh? Holy jumping. This guy's done this for a while. Lots of experience. It's pretty sweet. Someone stopped beside me. It's funny, they thought I was with the forestry, I guess, because I'm in a sweet-ass looking pickup truck and, you know, whatever. Are you with the forestry? No, no, man, but I like the smell of it. That's what I said to him. Oh, okay. And they left. Well, that's kind of cool. He's got, I don't know, maybe he can get the rest in the last load here. Gotta move up a little closer, maybe. Mind you, I've got this air on full, mostly got them on. I got the air conditioner on pretty much full fan speed right now. Actually, it is full fan speed, and it's not blowing too bad, but something seems weird still to me, but we'll run with her for a bit, see what happens. That's pretty freaking cool. I think, well, I don't know how tall that machine is, like cab height, it's probably 12, 14 feet, and he's got, I don't know, probably 18, almost 20 foot high stack there in the middle. Oh, one branch. Made her. Oh, crap. Now you're screwed. Are ya? It's kind of not really meant for grabbing little things like that, but you might have her now. Oh, crap. Lost her again. That's alright. That is freaking cool, I must say. I like these things. That'd be a fun job. Be all air conditioned in that cab too. Oh, it'd be just awesome. Look at that, spins it right around. Freaking cool. Plunk. So yeah, I don't know how many more they're gonna pull out of here, but holy jumping, there's probably 1,000 logs laying there. And then there's the big pile behind us too, right? There he goes. He says, I'm done. Put my Dewey down here and we'll go get another load. Oh, I wish I could go there with him. That'd be freaking awesome. I don't know where he's going in to the bush here, but there's probably a guy in there that's you know, cutting the trees down. Zing! It's pretty sweet. I better get out of his way. Okay, we're home. We're gonna crack open the lid here and see how things are looking. Sounds like the fans are running already. They probably haven't shut off yet. It's so friggin' hot. So, I would be kind of expecting to see quite a bit of moisture collecting and dripping, which it is. It's dripping down there, but for some reason, I don't know where the heck it's going. It's not dripping on the ground. But this line here is, well, it's pretty cold. I'm not too sure exactly why it's dripping where it's dripping from. Way down that silver protector cover thing. But I mean, it should be dribbling on the ground here somewhere, and I don't see nothing. Which kind of seems, oh, maybe it is a bit now. Okay, I'm just not thinking right. She's collecting some moisture, so I guess she's working pretty good. I don't know if I'm even shooting in the right spot, but it's dripping down off a freaking weird spot, that's for sure. It's dripping down off your freaking exhaust pipes. Look how rusty they are, man. In a weird spot to be gripping, but I guess, you know, you kind of think it'd be up here forever. But I guess, I don't know, it's whatever. Yeah, it won't take long to go rusty. Holy frig, eh? Oh well, more money. She is dripping, so that's a good thing, I guess. It's kind of what I wanted to see. Oh. Dripping really good down in there. I don't know if you can see that or not, but that line's staying fairly cold. And what's the compressor doing? Yeah, it's not running right now. Oh, yes, it is running now. I don't know if I'm showing you the right spot or not. but
yeah, I guess it seems all right. I don't know. It's just me, maybe. Just me. It's just me, maybe. I don't know. Let's go back in here and see if she's cold in here still. Yeah, that's not too bad. I guess that's not too bad. Maybe it is alright then. I don't know. Sometimes it's weird. It seems to work fine. Other times it doesn't seem to work fine. So, I don't know. Maybe it's... I don't know. I don't know.
Maybe it's just me being like a super paranoid or something. Maybe that's the way it's supposed to be. But comparing models, we'll say here, in the Toyota, it'll freaking freeze you out of it. You got to turn it down. This, it's like running like pretty much full tilt the whole time. And it's comfortable, but it's not ice cold. So I don't know. Maybe they got a better system in their cars, in the Toyota cars, than they do in these things or something. I don't know. But I'll tell you, when I worked at my rental place in town here, I had an old 1994 Ford pickup truck, 150. The old style with the two fuel tanks on it, which took a lot of fuel. It had such incredibly cold air conditioning in it that if it was pointing on the windows or whatever, or anything like that, it would actually cool down the whole thing so much that the moisture would start collecting on the outside of the window. It got so freaking cold in that truck. It was really cold. It was like sitting in a freaking meat locker, like a freezer almost. But this, no, not near, not a quarter of what the coldness that thing put out. So I don't know. Maybe it's a total different system nowadays and it's not quite as good. That was probably an old R12 refrigerant, which I think was a lot colder than this 134A they're using now. That could be part of the problem. I don't know. The R12 was a little harder on the environment. I guess if it got into the air, right, it would deplete our ozone and make us feel hotter, which it's doing. It's a freaking, the sun is so hot feeling now. But I guess the 134A is supposed to be better for the environment, but I guess maybe it doesn't cool as much. I don't know. I think I heard that somewhere once, but I don't know. Who knows? I'm pretty sure it's 134A in the car, and it's freaking really cold. Like, ice cold, so I don't know. Air conditioning, who knows? But, yeah, anyway, so I guess I better get out of here and get home instead. It looks like there's some clouds coming. Hang on. I don't know if those are really stormy-looking clouds, but they're definitely freaking moving. Holy man, if you got a kite up that high, it would just snap the string right out of your fingers. That would be awesome. Even down here is windy enough. Look at the trees blowing. So, yeah. Yeah, but I slept in the trailer last night. Oh, it was freaking minus 18 in there. It was awesome. And it wasn't really that super hot out last night, but it was so freaking cold that, you know, and it's pretty well insulated too, that the compressor and that would actually shut off for like 25 minutes or so. And then you hear it back on again, and then you'd feel the cold really coming in. And it actually woke me up pretty much every time it started to get really cold, because it was like, I was shivering. I'm like, this is awesome. I love this. But yeah, so our president of the board on the cemetery here, he actually owns and operates a HVAC company. So heating, venting, and air conditioning. And he installs all kinds of stuff, you know, furnaces, air conditioners. I mentioned to him a while ago, can you put one in our house for us? Oh, yeah, sure. And I don't know, he hasn't done her yet, but I texted him this morning, like, so any chance that, you know, we could maybe put an air conditioner unit in today to our house? And he just typed back, no. Capital N-O. I'm like, oh. So I guess he's pretty busy. There'll be a lot of people calling, my air conditioning's not working. So he's got to go, they go and fix it all, whatever, you know. And so I can imagine he was pretty busy. So that'll be hopefully coming this summer sometime, hopefully. You know, not maybe in September, but should have thought of her, I guess, later last year or something. He could have put it in, you know, oh yeah, I got lots of time now. But now this time of year, no, he's swamped. So I thought I'd just ask, see what happens, you know. The only thing you can say is no, or yeah, we'll be there in half an hour or whatever. But I kind of imagine putting in a great big unit, you know, like a central air conditioner for your house, is actually kind of a fairly big job. Because you got to think, you got to find the place outside for the unit to sit, okay? You got to put down some kind of foundation, some patio stones or something, whatever, for it to stand on, sit on. You'd have to run in, one line in from the air conditioner, that would be your cold line, into your furnace, and the other line back out, back to the outside condenser thingy, right? To the condenser and then the compressor and then back in, and around she goes, right? And it goes into your furnace, into that heat exchanger, cooler, air exchanger thing, and your fan power blows the air through it, the forced air blows through it, and then cools your house, right? And then it sucks in the moisture and the moist air out of your house through the cold return vents and then through again, right? It's a vicious cycle, right around she goes. So, you know, you got to drill those two holes, you got to run those two lines in, you got to install that in the furnace, you got to run power from the box, hydro box, out to the air conditioner. You'd have to do probably a little bit of wiring for the thermostat up to the upstairs, which I think I've already got a thermostat installed, one of those digital ones that has the cool on one side, off, and then heat on the other side. So that's all good. you know, they'd have to hook all that crap up, and then I guess charge the system up, you know, like charge the Freon, whatever it's called in that thing, charge that up, and then test her, you know, like that's probably a good half a day, maybe a three quarter of a day job to install that. I don't know, you know, it'd be a fair bit of work, I would think. So it's like, yeah, they'd probably have to book that for like, you know, like a day almost for it install. I don't know. Depends, I guess, all on what size of system you put in too, right? So, but yeah, anyways, so I kind of want to leave my window down a hair, but, ooh, not that much. I also don't want to get rain in here, but I want a little bit of ventilation, but it's not going to let much out. I guess it doesn't hurt the vehicle if it sits in here 900 degrees, so I'll shut her down. But anyways, I've been rambling way longer than I was planning on. But it's time to definitely go home. 31 degrees still right now. And tonight it's supposed to go down to 12. That's a big drop. Pretty much feel it, I think, real fast. So anyways, you guys have a good night. Thanks for watching. Tomorrow we'll get some Coleman stuff out. Maybe. And see if they'll light. Prime them up. Pump them up. See if they'll light. I know they got these little piston things in there on the little pumper things to pump the air that are like leather, so they might be shot. They might be totally screwed right off the bat. I don't know. No idea. So, but those parts I think you can get at Canadian Tire over here even, so whatever. They're probably plastic now, not leather anymore. But go away, bug. So anyways, thanks again for watching. Have a good night. We'll catch you maybe tomorrow for some Coleman fun.